welcome to the first of our programs from the Paris Air Show. Now, excuse the noise, but we're coming in a most interesting way with the Embraer's KC390, the real multi-role airlifter. Real fantastic ride in. This is the aircraft that's going to be handed over to the Brazilian Air Force straight after the show. But here at Paris, they're going to be trying very hard to reach an international audience. Well, while it's pretty exciting up here, down on the ground, Andy Marl is telling me he's got a lot to talk about as well. So I hope it's good down there, Andy, and a bit quieter as well.
Yes, Alan, feet almost firmly on the ground, but just time to remind you of the news, and indeed everyone, the Aerospace Media Awards of 2019 awarded We Are Finn the Innovation in Aerospace Journalism and Publishing Award. So well done to everyone on the team here at We Are Finn. And rather fitting that we're stood here in front of the Israeli-built aviation aircraft in the Paris Static Park, making its debut here, the aircraft called Alice. This is the first all-electric, zero-emissions regional commuter aircraft to be shown, and its 9 passengers will be able to cruise at 275 miles an hour with a maximum range of 650 miles and with a half hour of recharging time for every hour in the air.
This is going to be the cheapest direct operating cost aircraft ever built for this size category. We're at roughly $200 a flight hour. That's a fraction, that's roughly a fifth of the cost of the equivalently sized and equivalently performing turboprop. And we believe this is not only the future of regional flight, we believe this is the future of regional transportation as a whole.
UAVs are growing in number at the air shows, and Elbit Systems' Hermes 45, a small tactical unmanned aircraft system, made its first public appearance on the Paris Static display. The UAV combines extended range and duration with point launch and recovery to and from land and maritime platforms for full ISTAR capabilities. Hermes 45 is operated by a 2-person crew, launched from a short onboard platform rail, and is recovered by an automated spot landing system.
And the big news from the first day of the show came from Airbus with the launch of the A321 XLR, extra long range. It's going to be capable of flying 4,700 miles with 200 passengers on board. That means it's bringing together places like Barcelona and Chicago, for example. First customer was Steven Udo Haase's Air Lease Corporation for 27 of the type. He said the new XLR will go further than the 757s and make a 30% cost and fuel reduction. Fuel efficiency is a big talking point here, and so too is reducing the huge cost of training. One French company, Elixir Aircraft, is showing its light trainer, which will slash the cost of training thanks to its low fuel use.
When you put a modern engine with a low fuel consumption, 10 to 15 liters per hour, you reduce dramatically as well the fuel consumption. So the objective is to offer an aircraft with 40 euros per hour of just fuel and maintenance.
Now, Russian helicopters were impressing with the flexibility of their new Ansat helicopter, which is making its debut at the Paris Air Show. And there was a troop of Russian gymnasts who were bending over backwards to reinforce the point. We'll hear more about the Ansat during the week as it performs in the Daily Flying Air Show.
And this year's show is going to be all about milestones as well, with Embraer and Airbus both celebrating 50th anniversaries, as well, of course, as the moon landings.
And there was another big milestone as well from CFM, the engine maker. They had an even bigger number to talk about.
We just passed 1 billion flight hours with our engines, with a CFM 56 engine. And it's sometimes hard to understand what 1 billion flight hour is. We carried 35 billion people. Imagine it's 5 times the population of Earth.
And that's the equivalent to 115,000 years of service, or 400,000 return trips to the moon.
Well, there's certainly going to be a lot to see here at Le Bourget this week.
We're going to be looking at mergers and acquisitions and just exactly how that's thinning down the supply chain.
And I'm going to be looking at artificial intelligence and the impact it's having on the manufacturing and aftermarket activities.
So plenty to see. Join us again tomorrow for the wrap from day 2.
And of course, you can find the latest news at wearefin.com. Thanks for watching.